Welcome everyone, parents, governors, Hillcrest staff, and of course our students to our online prize giving and awards celebration for 2021. It is important to celebrate after a year of challenge and difficulties. We've a lot to be thankful for and a lot to celebrate. What a year it has been. Who would have imagined this time last year that we would have spent so much time in online teaching and some students would be doing it even now. So sure were we that we would be able to return to full in-school teaching last September that we decided to return to teaching 2 weeks early in August. This year, our students have had to be even more resilient, independent, curious and determined to survive and to thrive. This year, students have weathered the uncertainty and have taken external exams in school. The excellent organisation of our exams team has enabled them to have the best opportunity to be successful in Cambridge, AQA, Pearson and EdExcel exams, while offering the flexibility for those needing to do internal exams at home. 2 years ago, I referred to this quote from the first African woman to receive the Nobel Peace Prize, Wangari Maathai. She said, "It's the little things that citizens do. That's what will make the difference. My little thing is planting trees." This year, I would like to take this quote and expand upon it. My role model, as for many others, is Nelson Mandela. His bravery and firm principle stance on many issues still resounds throughout the world today. His lack of bitterness and ability to forgive those who have wronged him and his family is challenging and an inspiring example to us all. This quote is from him, which at first seems to contradict the previous one. He said, "There is no passion to be found playing small in settling for a life that is less than the one you're capable of living." I've only recently discovered this quote, and it has stuck in my memory. It is a message for us all. In a similar vein, one of our parents has this stuck on the front of their school truck. "One life, live it." We all get one chance in life, so what are we going to do with it? How are we going to make a difference? Will we take the easy way out when offered an opportunity? We are here to celebrate students who have begun to make this a habit, who have achieved despite the strangeness and the difficulties, and ensured that this year did not stop them from living. Perhaps we've had to change our view of what living looks like with the new normal. Perhaps it's the same, but we're learning to appreciate it more and more. The opportunities for taking the easy way out have certainly been present this year, but Hillcrest has looked to enhance the provision of our online learning to ensure that we offer the best that we are able to offer the students. From a standing start in March 2020, we were able to offer a near full online timetable to all of our pupils. Improvements from this time onwards have come thick and fast. Online apps to improve marking, CAM scanner, to enable exams to be conducted online, exams.net, interactive remote quizzes, Kahoot and Mentimeter, online parental consultation appointments through School Cloud, resources for online learning through our VLE, large-scale parental consultation regarding the way that things are going through go-to meetings, and full support for the mental health of our pupils through girls and boys chats, as well as tutorial sessions to meet up with their tutor once a fortnight. We've also tried to give full and free information regarding the health of our community, being honest with you all, including when infection has struck. When we have reopened, we've successfully enabled all to access education without the need to close the school down. Each of these changes may be small in nature, but when combined together, make a big difference to everyone in the school. A Mount Kenya-sized thank you must go to all who've made this happen. It's been a real team effort from teachers, the IT team, the marketing team, the admin team, the finance team. It's what makes this school great. The combination of governors, parents, staff and students working together with a common purpose continues to deliver. We will wait for the external confirmation of these when the external exams results are out on August the 12th. As there were no external trips and fixtures, these cannot be reviewed. This is a real shame as they enhance our curriculum so much and create those memories that are so important. We were, however, recently able to offer a day of in-school bonding for Year 9, which was greatly appreciated, giving all the opportunity to let off some steam after a year of being cooped up and after a week of exams. The PE department have also been able to offer internal fixtures between year groups, and we will end the year with a similar arrangement on Friday of this week. Swimming sessions too were able to return. and we will wait to see what the situation is like in September, but hopefully there'll be a return to greater normalcy. We've missed all of these events so much, and we thank everyone for their patience and for their understanding. The lack of these opportunities this year will serve to make us savour them even more as and when they're able to return. Fortunately, our debate season was not lost. Wednesday lunchtimes in Term 1 were lively and strongly contested. The speaking skills gained have already borne fruit in the many who so willingly and articulately engaged and challenged us in form assemblies which will have run for every week since Easter 2020. We have followed our themes of the week, highlighting important worldwide events that do not necessarily have COVID content. Such as apparently small activities still loom large. Thank you to Mr. Tumor, who has worked hard to select motions and brief participants and ensure impartiality. This in normal time is challenging enough, but this year, with some people not being even in the country, it was an even greater challenge. As you'd expect, the option to go for small was rejected. Now, looking ahead for all of us, but especially those who are leaving, what do these words of Nelson Mandela mean? There is no passion to be found in playing small, in settling for a life that is less than the one that you're capable of living. I'm sure you can already see that there are several features. The first of which is be ambitious and independent. What is it that you want to do? Be passionate and be determined. And as the car sticker reminds us, you get one shot at this life. Try not to have regrets and don't settle for second best. Elon Musk, the co-founder of PayPal, made $100 million from selling it. He used that money and he invested it in another venture of his, which is electrification of cars and SpaceX. It would have been so easy for him just to settle back and think, I've done it, I don't need to be ambitious anymore. Secondly, be willing to take risks, be curious. It was a huge risk to come to Africa for us. The benefits in broadening our exposure to different cultures and races and challenges have been significant, and we are better people as a result of being here. Books and tuition videos don't really cut it. Thirdly, be determined. You will fail. You will goof up. We all do. If we're honest, what happens after that is what will make the difference. If you give up, you're settling for small and a life that is less than the one you're capable of living. There are endless examples of famous people who refused to give up. They had the determination and independence to continue. Edison and the light bulb. Thomas Edison's teachers said that he was, and I quote, too stupid to learn anything. Edison was fired from his first two jobs for being non-productive. As an inventor, Edison made 1,000 unsuccessful attempts at inventing the light bulb. Dyson, the vacuum cleaner manufacturer, similarly tried for 15 years to get his bagless system to work and be accepted. J.K. Rowling, it took her 7 years to get books that she had written published. The list is endless of people who've tried and then tried and then tried again. These three lessons apply to all of us, irrespective of age. Many of you in this school have wowed us with just what you're capable of achieving whilst you've been here. Many more have gone before you, and we've been inspired by the success stories in the bulletin over the years. Follow their footsteps and make a difference, and give a legacy that will live on after you. Listen to Toya Najahi for a personal example from one of our alumni. She'll be speaking to you after I've finished. There are teachers here who've made a big difference and who are now moving on to new challenges in their lives. Edison Gitonga, who joined us from GEMS School and has been part of our strong swimming coaching team ever since. Katerina Barakos, who joined us from the UK as head of drama 2 years ago, now to be a full-time mum to her newborn. Katya Moshi, who has had to leave us to prioritise family needs. Elena Troy, who's made such a difference speaking into the lives of our pupils, always available to listen, help out and advise. Many of you who are going to North American universities are going as a result of her advice and guidance. As she leaves to go back to America, she'll take a little bit of Africa away with her. Phoebe Wanjugu, the school nurse, who has already left the school, but leaves a legacy assisting so many with the inevitable bumps and scrapes that a busy, active school and boarding facility always delivers. Finally, Jackie Guest, Someone who has never settled for second best in anything in life, and certainly not in this school. She is someone who's given her all for this school over many decades. She started teaching in Hillcrest in 1984 when I was still at university. And even though she's part-time in contract, she's full-time at heart and indeed. Frequently here on Saturdays and Sundays, her culinary contributions are the stuff of legend, as is her source of alumni and her organizational ability. This prize-giving event is largely down to her. She will leave a massive hole in the school that will be hard to fill. She will be missed. I will miss her, the staff will miss her, but most of all, the students will miss her. Her impact globally is enormous. She has delivered across the generations, enriching the lives of all she's come in contact with. I'm sure she will keep in touch with us, but she will always be welcome back here. Once again, I'm indebted to all the staff of Hillcrest. We are blessed to have such a committed team. This became even more clear to me after my recent accident. I'd like to thank those that helped me personally, professionally, and have supported me when times have been tough. Timna has ensured I stayed healthy when I was incapacitated. Drivers who transported me to meetings around Nairobi. Teachers who supported and encouraged. The SLT have been invaluable ensuring through their highly competent hard work that the school continues to run as seamlessly as possible. Students too have been wonderful, but what else would you expect? The values that we have aimed to instill in them, determination, independence, curiosity and respect, have been in evidence. They constantly remind me of why I came into teaching many years ago. They are also our reason to celebrate today. Virtually, yes, but celebration of such achievements recognize who we are and what we continue to be. That is so vital. Pandemic or no pandemic, that must not stop us affirming these attributes. Many congratulations go to them all for rising up through the difficulties of the year, challenging those difficulties to complete what they needed to do to make it through successfully to the end. These awards have been earned, and the praise, prizes, and successes are thoroughly deserved. Press on from here, wherever you find yourself from September onwards. This is just the start of the journey that we are all on. If you've not been given a public recognition, what are you going to do about it? Will it spur you on, or will you accept defeat? Be ambitious, be willing to take risks, and be prepared for setbacks. My final words of the year are those of Nelson Mandela once again. There is no passion to be found in playing small, in settling for a life that is less than the one you're capable of living. I must also thank my wife, who supported me throughout my time as head teacher. She's my fiercest critic, but also my rock and my best friend. My final thanks must go to you, the parents, for your unwavering support, encouragement, as well as the challenges that you provided for me and for the school. I will always listen to your views and, where possible, implement your ideas for the benefit of everyone. I don't have all the answers, but just like iron sharpens iron, you've made us better and will no doubt help us to be even better in 2021-2022. You, like us, will never settle for small. I look forward to welcoming many of you back to Hillcrest on Tuesday, August the 31st, 2021, when we will reopen. Stay safe over the summer and look out for the regular communication as we adapt and continue to build to a no doubt ever-changing environment here in Kenya. I'm now about to hand over to Toyin Ajayi.
Hi everybody, I'm Toyin Ajayi. I graduated from Hillcrest Secondary School in 1998. And I've been asked to share a few reflections and thoughts about my time at Hillcrest. And I think when I look back in the years that have passed since I left Nairobi and left Hillcrest, about what made my experience so remarkable. Since then, I finished in 1998, as I said. I moved to California, to the United States, to Stanford for university. I lived in San Francisco for a while after that, and then I moved to the United Kingdom. I went to Cambridge for my master's degree and to King's College in London for medical school before spending some time in Sierra Leone and then returning to the US, to Boston, and now to New York, where I've been for about the last decade. And nowhere in my journeys and in my path have I been in a place that was as diverse as Hillcrest. Growing up and learning at such a formative time in my life in an environment that took for granted just the diversity, the heterogeneity of backgrounds, of languages spoken, of skin color, of gender and sexual orientation. All of these things were just baked in the water in the way that we went to school. And that's just a gift. And I didn't think very much about it because I took it for granted so much. But in retrospect, I cherish this. I think it shaped the way that I view humans and the way that I view my role in the world and in society as really about transcending the more kind of immediate and obvious things that may separate us or make us look different. Getting down to it, we are so similar as humans and share so many values and virtues and challenges and desires. And I think growing up in an environment like Hillcrest was really powerful for me. I think the second thing that strikes me is the opportunities for leadership. I was head girl at Hillcrest, and I was head of house, I guess. So I'm trying to remember all the different activities we did. It feels like such a long time ago. But I remember that there were so many different activities that we were part of and so many different opportunities for leadership for people with lots of different backgrounds and skills. And at that time, I wasn't ever the top of the class. Academics, I was okay at academics, but I wasn't the best. There's so many smart people at Hillcrest. But to be singled out for leadership because of skills and attributes that I had that that perhaps weren't as obvious, the ability to kind of inspire other people to join, to think creatively about how to solve problems together, to bring people along on decision-making. Those are all skills that have been really, in fact, if anything, the skills that have made me the most successful, and to have them kind of identified early in school, in an environment where I could learn, I was still forming, and I had teachers and mentors to supervise and support and to inspire me was really incredible. And I'm not sure what people saw in me then as a 16 or 17 year old who really hadn't figured out who she was, but they saw something in me that gave me the confidence to think that I could be a leader and that I could engender the respect and the following of my peers. And that as I've gone on in my career to work as a physician, to build a business, to grow an organization, that early vote of confidence that that the school had in me and those skills that someone saw as nascent in me and helped me to cultivate during my year as head girl was really important and really powerful. And then I think, the value of play, I think, is another thing that I really appreciate Hillcrest for. There were so many sports and so many different ways of exploring creativity and teamwork and competition. And sports, I'm sure that's still the case today, but sports were a huge, huge center point and anchor point for school life. And playing on a team, finding joy in competition, working really hard, but also not taking yourself too seriously, exploring your bodies, being outside, all of that is, I think, again, really important skills for the future that that the school environment gave me. And I think of, myself as an early athlete at Hillcrest and the tenacity that fosters in you, the ability to fall, get up, keep going, to lose, to win, to keep trying, to working as part of a team. I think these are, again, these are life lessons and life skills that I think were so powerful and important. As always, though, there are things that I wish had happened differently for me. And I think it's worthwhile to just say them out loud and, offer this up to you as students and to faculty. I wish that I'd learned more about my own history as an African woman. We did not learn really African history or literature in any way with the level of intensity and focus with which we learned kind of European history and literature. And there was a real kind of continuation of colonialism, I think, in the education system that I experienced that I hope has changed. And if it hasn't, I encourage you to think about changing it, because despite and in parallel to educating people within the British system, we're also educating people in Africa to be leaders in Africa and across the globe, to be leaders, hopefully, who take the incredible privilege they have of this amazing education, the diversity of skills and experiences that they gain and of people that they encounter, and apply that to helping others, to improving the lot of others, to improving the world. And you can't do that if you don't understand history, and if you don't understand art, and if you don't understand the diversity and heterogeneity of voices in history and art. And I regret, and I sometimes I like rail against it. You know, I felt so ignorant when I left Kenya, came to the United States to start my my university studies, and then to start my career. And I realized I didn't know anything about the history of my own people. And I didn't know anything about the history of people like me who had been taken from Africa by slavers and brought to the United States, and what that means for the history of people of color in America, and what that means for the history of people of color in the United Kingdom. And I didn't understand in its fullest detail how Hillcrest came to be and how so many of the institutions that we took for granted in Kenya came to be. And that was a failure of my education. And I hope that we are asking more from our educational institutions today than I received, even as I am grateful, so deeply grateful for the incredible experience I had as a student at Hillcrest. I don't think that that I would have been as successful as an adult, as an entrepreneur, as a leader, had I not had so many of the foundational and formative experiences that I was able to gain at Hillcrest. So just offering some thoughts and some real gratitude. I congratulate all of you graduates as you leave and move to explore new domains in your lives in this world after the crazy year we've had. I encourage you to hold on to the core attributes, the values that you've gained at Hillcrest. I think they will serve you well. I encourage you to figure out ways to stay in touch and connected with your friends. I know that one of the bittersweet components of being so privileged as to have the education that you have is that people scatter after you graduate. People will go all over the world to pursue university and the next steps in their lives, more so than if you'd grown up or been educated in a school that had less of an international focus and less opportunity available to the students. And so it takes more work to hold on to your friends and hold on to your relationships and remember the things that you've been through together, but it is worth it. When I spend time with my old Hillcrest friends, and I've been really fortunate to have a few that I've stayed really close with, there's no greater gift than to have community and friendship with people who've known you and known just the unique circumstances in which you were raised and were educated, even as you make new friends and have new experiences in your life. So good luck and congratulations, and I wish you all the very best.
Hi, parents and students and fellow colleagues at Hillcrest. I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Mrs. Kira Chana, and I'm head of year 9. I'm going to read out all the prizes won by year 9 this year. So starting off, I'd like to just clarify, significant contribution is for a student who has really put in a great amount of effort throughout the year. It's nothing to do really with the exam performance. And then the prize in the subject is somebody, once again, not necessarily attached to exam performance, but somebody who has really stood out through the whole 3 terms with homework, effort, classroom behavior, and their general demeanor with the subject. Okay, so I'm going to start. So significant contribution in Kiswahili goes to Nasibu Ali. Significant contribution in food science goes to Max Andrade. Significant contribution in art goes to Maya Barnes. Significant contribution in physics goes to Joe Dutton Devan. Significant contribution in Spanish goes to Zoe Rose Hagelberg. Significant contribution in learning support goes to Ian Kiambi. Significant contribution in Spanish goes to Heather Kirui. Significant contribution in Kiswahili goes to Naomi Kwea. Significant contribution in geography goes to Alpha Letich. Significant contribution in history goes to Jacqueline Mbumba. In food science, Joshua Newnham. In mathematics, Pamela Weber. Significant contribution in Spanish and food science goes to Myra Khan. Significant contribution in food science and art goes to Imara Patel. Significant contribution in Spanish and girls sport goes to Jennifer Titch. So those are all the significant contributions. I'm now going to come onto the prizes, and there are some students who have won prizes as well as significant contributions. So, the prize in girls sport goes to Reese Gore. The prize for boys sport goes to Fraser Mestag. Significant contribution in Spanish and a prize in English as an additional language, which is EAL, goes to Iris Oosterhaven. Significant contribution in food science and art, and the prize in design technology goes to Maya Williams. Significant contribution in English, mathematics, chemistry, and drama goes to Ethan Kimandi. Significant contribution in Spanish, computer science, academic PE, and the prize in physics goes to Dylan Kinua. Significant contribution in Spanish, mathematics, art, design technology, academic PE, and boys sport goes to Lyndon Darker. Significant contribution in biology, physics, chemistry, boys sport, and the prize in food science goes to Tarquin Matthews. Significant contribution in music and French and physics, and the prize in art and mathematics goes to Weyua Kaguchia. The prize in Spanish, biology, and music goes to Rani Shah. Significant contribution in computer science, and the prize in French, Kiswahili, and chemistry goes to Elsie Ashuma. Significant contribution in French, design technology, and the prize in English, history, art, and computer science goes to Tasmina Minja. And significant contribution in French, biology, art, and the prize in geography, food science, drama, and academic PE goes to Alia Weber. Well done to all the Year 9s. You have been absolutely amazing, not just to prize winners or students who have won a significant contribution. Generally, I have been very, very, very impressed with all the Year 9s.
Good evening, everyone. I'm going to read out the prize winners and significant contributors in Year 10. I'll start off with the significant contributions. Significant contribution to Kiswahili, David Shira. Music, Liana Azing. Academic PE, Talia Harrell. BTech Hospitality, Pablo Kavuma. Both art is shared between Zoe Kleftakis and Maria Lovatelli. Geography, Kauzu Mukuzi. Kiswahili, Juliet Muigai. History, Jeremy Nyomodi. Business Studies, Irene Ogola. Art, Sarah Patel. Computer Science, Pragati Prabka. Physics, D.R. Aichura. Design and Technology, Alexandra Van Tongeren. Art, Zara Wali Mohammed. Tyrese Wazika gets the boy sport. Design and Technology and BTech Business, Ivana Avellino. Biology and Global Perspectives, Evelyn Fevre. English Language and Drama, Lorato Kamchira. Learning Support and Mathematics, Senele Liswe Modletsi. French and Boys Sport, Gail Schupberg. ICT and Combined Sciences, Keith Sigay. I will now proceed to read the prize winners, some of whom have also made significant contributions in a number of subjects. Girls Sports goes and significant contribution to English Literature, Samara Gautama. English Language, Anamika Govani. Boys Sport, Amari Hayakawa. Spanish, Amina Mokia. Business Studies, Siana Parik. Music and significant contribution to physics, Nema Chekoko. Art and Global Perspectives, Saskia Lutzma. Kiswahili and Combined Sciences, Angela Otieno. Significant contribution to mathematics, chemistry, girls' sports, as well as the English Additional Language Prize, goes to Emanuela Mubalama. Significant contribution to Spanish, academic PE, and the prize for boys sports goes to Joshua Denga. English, significant contribution to English literature and BTEC hospitality, and the geography prize goes to Selam Teshome. Design and technology also goes to Selam Teshome. French, Annika Ubi. Annika has also got the prize for BTEC hospitality. Sohani Kotecha has the English Literature Prize, as well as significant contribution to French and biology. She also has the ICT Prize. Suhana Vasani has made a significant contribution to French, biology, chemistry, food and nutrition, and she gets the prizes for history and academic PE. Carolina Fusilo has made significant contribution to Spanish, and she gets the prizes for French, food and nutrition, drama, and global perspectives. Chanel Shah has made significant contribution to French and has got the prizes or won the prizes for mathematics, biology, chemistry, physics, and computer science. Those are our year 10 students who have done exceptionally well, and I'd like to encourage the others to be on the list next year. I'll start off with the significant contributors. Art, Ume Salama Adamji. Biology, Elaine Avellino. Drama, Alicia Entenu. Global perspectives, Saskia Gushi. English as an additional language, Ji Fang Jia. Geography, Muturi Kiyama. Music, Emma Noni Kibuchi. Food and nutrition goes to Jean-Luc Lance and Catherine Matu. Design and technology, Connor McCann. Kiswahili, Nicole Njuguna. Art, Kia Patel. Design and technology again to Max Redinger. Kiswahili, Jeremy Wabuti. Mathematics and boys sports, Bennett Fieldman. Mathematics and global perspectives, Jody Glover. French and art, Shema Kakiza. French and physics, Natasha Seaton. Mathematics, ICT to Tiffany Massini. Physics, food and nutrition to Jared Williams. Now I will read out the prize winners. Again, some of them have also equally made a significant contribution in a wide range of subjects. Music, the music prize goes to Gakenia Kagushia. Drama to Ian Lever. Biology to Maina Masharia. Kiswahili to Stuart Marisa Murabu. Girl sports to Lisa Musunga. Boys sport to Alvin Muthi. English language to Amber Okello. Food and nutrition to Kiana Patel. Design and technology and significant contribution to history, Ella Thorne. Rispa Okello has made significant contribution to mathematics, to chemistry, and computer science. Thilasoni Musuku has made significant contribution to learning support, mathematics, and has the Boys Sports Prize. Frank Uiragie has made significant contribution to English literature and business studies, and has won the prize for ICT. Dia Chaga has made significant contribution to English language, mathematics, biology, food and nutrition, while Julia Nora has made significant contribution to art and has won the prizes for French and English language. Nisha Ochola has made significant contribution to art and won the prizes for history and business studies. Amber Valesen has made significant contribution to girls' sports and won the prizes for geography and global perspectives. Samuel Scott has won the prizes for physics, for chemistry, for computer science. Dia Tanner has won the prizes for English literature, for mathematics, for physics, and for art. Right. Those are our year 11 winners for this academic year, and I would like to wish them well as they proceed into year 12.
Okay, year 12 prize winners. First, we have Hannah Abdi getting a significant contribution to mathematics, Amal Amin, contribution to English language, Simran Budabati, contribution to physics, Kanyeri Chegi, contribution to design technology, Alia Charongi, contribution to art, Sienna Chirono, contribution to art, Tadal Kamchira, contribution to physics, Jan Kemboy, contribution to BTEC Travel and Tourism, Eunice McKenna Kianda, contribution to geography, Kevin Musembi, contribution to design technology, Sonia Nyaya Cocker, contribution to BTEC Business, Paul Okobasu, contribution to art, Wendy Githinji, contribution to psychology and economics, Musimbi Masidza, contribution to chemistry and biology, Ian Munga, contribution to art and boys' sports, Leila Verlaysen, contribution to English literature and art. Okay, Thomas Bafoli, a prize in BTEC sport, Ariana Gautama, prize in girls' sport, Emmanuel Masedza, prize in travel and tourism, Keith Munga, prize in boys' sport, Dorcas Mwai, BTEC hospitality subsidiary, Lita Nduri, prize for music, Victoria Okumu, prize in BTEC hospitality diploma, Ria Vashisht, prize in physics, Gillian Wandera, prize in psychology. Then McKenna Mugambi, contribution to English literature, history and economics. Irene Juma, contribution to economics and a prize in history. Emma Langeveld, contribution to economics, a prize in English literature. Shandice Uwamahoro, contribution to mathematics and a prize in economics. Courtney Watson, contribution to biology and psychology and a prize in art. Matthew Amisi, prizes in design technology and computer science. Marcel Cullens, prizes in English language and ICT. Magdal Sala, prizes in chemistry and economics. Matea Mwangi, contribution to girls' sport, prizes in French and psychology. Dennis Samuel, contribution to boys' sport, prizes in mathematics and BTEC business. And Rediet Thai, contribution to chemistry, prizes in geography and biology.
I will be reading the year 13 prizes. And to start with, geography goes to, special contribution goes to Sari Moloimet. Special contribution in art goes to Blessing Dumu. Special contribution in mathematics, Ivan Juguna. Special contribution in French goes to Milan. Special contribution in physics goes to Stella Essing, as well as special contribution in mathematics. Now, for economics, the special contribution goes to Maliki Mwangi, as well as also in computer science. So those are the year 13 students who have been awarded special contribution by their teachers. The winner for geography is Alvaro Achola. The winner for BTEC hospitality is Olivia. The winner for psychology is Wanjiru Feldman. The winner for BTEC hospitality diploma is Jake Glover. The winner for design and technology is William Meyer. The winner for mathematics is Abdullahi Wasame. Then the winner for BTEC sport and special contribution in girls sport is Laura Gitahu. The winner for boys sport and special contribution in business studies is Matthew Githinji. The winner for French and special contribution in psychology is Tara. The winner for art and special contribution for English language is Giovanna. The winner for BTEC business and special contribution in law is Daniel Mutisia. And the winner for biology and special contribution economics is Nina Redinger. Now, got Doris, special contribution in maths, biology, and psychology. Then we've got Tariq, BTEC hospitality, BTEC business, and BTEC travel tourism under special contributions. Now, then you've got Janice, who has won a prize in law and has got special contribution in both history and economics. Now, Christine Gishuhi, winner in English literature, special contribution in chemistry and biology. Ethiel has won the prize for girls' sport and also a special contribution in art and further maths. Then you got Ryan Duma, who has won computer science and special contribution in maths and boys' sport. Then Tiffany Zimbi, who has won business studies and special contribution in literature and psychology. Now, last but not least, in the year 13, we have got the two special students who have won prizes across all their three subjects. So the first one is Collins Businge, winner in English language, history, and economics. And Dev Shah, who has won a prize in further mathematics, physics, and chemistry. Well done to all the year 13. It's been a special year, guys. I know we were all worried about whether we'll have the exams. Now that has come now to pass. We are also worried about whether we'll have graduation, which we just enjoyed yesterday, at least in-house. My apologies to those who had traveled, especially the Ugandans, who were not able to be with us yesterday. But well done, and we are hoping that come August 10th, we will be enjoying the fruits of your hard work. That is when the results will be out. All the very best as you move to your universities. Well done, the year 13.
Good evening to all my fellow students, parents, and teachers. Today marks the end of yet another school year, and it seems, well, at least for me, you never quite realize that you're at the end until this very moment, when all the awards have been given, and you say goodbye till you meet again in the coming year. For many, this cycle will continue, but for myself and others such as teachers, this cycle is coming to a bittersweet end. This has brought me to reflect upon the years past and what I've taken from my time at Hillcrest and school as a whole. Through this reflection, I've come to find that there's been a main factor in life that has defined the type and frequency of success I've experienced in school and beyond its borders, which I've come to share with you today. This is the factor of consistency. Consistency can decide everything. I believe it is the reason we either do or do not achieve our goals and desires and aspirations, and not just from an academic perspective, but from a personal one as well. I began to understand this fact at the start of year 11, where I feared about the negative outcome of my exams and how I wasn't prepared. As a result, I began to seek counsel amongst my friends and peers who had received large success in their academics. And the one thing I took from them and their techniques of preparation is that they had always been preparing for their tests weeks and possibly months before. Imagine my shock. Someone like myself, who used to do guesswork in exams, studying only a week or even a day before. Realizing this, it brought me to think about the quote in the book Think and Grow Rich, written by Napoleon Hill, where he talks about persistence, stating that persistence is an essential factor in the procedure of transmuting desire into its monetary equivalent. What I think he's saying is that nothing you place value upon is ever acquired without consistent and thought-out action towards the goals you wish to achieve. That's why what we choose to place our focus on is often what leads and governs our actions and thus the direction our lives go in. So this forced me to realize that the grades I so desperately desired were never going to be achieved within a week or a month, but required diligent and consistent focus over a considerable margin of time. So I'd ask you this question: what do you wish to achieve, regardless of it being an academic pursuit or not? And do your consistent actions reflect and aid in the achievement of these goals? For the teachers, do the lengths at which you go in your teaching consistently provide complete comprehension required by each student to constantly deepen and broaden their knowledge? For students, do you believe that you consistently place into action what your dreams and aspirations whisper you can become? Because goals without a plan that's consistently executed are just wishes. By this point, you must all be thinking, what am I on about? You can't make life, you can't plan everything, and nor can you make everything perfect. But being consistent isn't about perfection, but rather it's about creating a platform where the pursuit of your goals can be visualized and constantly worked on. So what I would implore all of you to take from this and ask yourself is, in what way has lack of consistency interfered in the goals and dreams you set for your life? And I say this not to discourage you, but as a reminder that it's never too late to start the journey of achieving the desires of your heart. All it takes is one intentional action followed by another. To end off, I'd like to thank all the parents and teachers for their support and investment in time in myself and peers, especially in these trying times we've faced over the past year and a half. I know it hasn't been easy. And I thank God for keeping us and those around us in good health through these times. Thank you all, and have a great evening.
And now for the final prize, which is the head of year prize, which is really, really difficult. But before I get into that, I just want to congratulate all the year nines as a whole year group, 58 of you. You've been absolutely amazing. You started the year online in September, joining a school, a new school for some of you, a new country. You all did an amazing job, and you came back in January with a lot of passion and ambition. So it's always difficult to choose one boy and one girl, and I do force Jackie to allow me to choose one boy and one girl in year nine who have really stood out for myself in the entire year. So for the girl, I'll start off with girls. I'm giving this to somebody who I see as a very warm personality, very endearing. She invites a lot of, people go to her to get help, whether it's academically or emotionally. She's got a very welcoming personality. Unfortunately, she's leaving, which makes me very, very, very sad. She's very enthusiastic in class. She's a critical thinker, so she thinks out of the box, and you can give her a problem and she'll just get on with it. Where she's going, she's going to be a great ambassador, because I think she would have really done well at Hillcrest. But we wish her well. Her family is moving to another country, and her name is Tasmina Minja. Well done, Tas. For the boy, I've chosen somebody who really does define the Hillcrest ethos. Comes from a family of parents. I think his mother came to Hillcrest. He's witty, got a very, very vibrant sense of humor, very cheerful, very sporty, but unfortunately hasn't really managed to excel in sports due to the lovely pandemic. He's, I think, going to really, really excel here in year 10 and year 11, and hopefully till year 13, and his name is Lyndon Darker. So well done, Taz and Lyndon. And I'd just like to give a special farewell to 5 year nines who are leaving. Makes me very sad, but we would like to wish them well to wherever they're going. Their names are Rani Shah, Imara Patel, Zoe Rose Hagelberg, Tasmina Minja, and Maya Barnes, who has already left. She is in Finland. And also, I would like to welcome a new year nine who joined yesterday, That was June the 23rd. Her name is Natasha Kemathi, so I'm sure she's going to have lots of summer holiday homework, and she will go into year 10. Thank you.
The Head of Year's prize for this year goes to a polite, friendly, and easygoing student who, despite the slowing down of activities due to the pandemic, has left an indelible mark. Academically, she is an enthusiastic learner who is determined to achieve the highest possible grades. This is supported by the positive attitude and a thirst for knowledge. Her teachers acknowledge that she does not stop until she has mastered the most challenging of topics. She is a very interesting personality in the sense that her quiet confidence wins her very many friends. She is supportive of others and a natural leader in any group. Her sporting prowess has many times put Hillcrest in a leading position in various sporting activities. I would like to present this prize to none other than Kiana Patel.
I've got this Head of Year prizes, and maybe just keeping with the 13th, this year has been very difficult because you're only here for a short while. Most of the time we were doing online learning, but two students caught my eye, and I decided that this year, the year 13 prize, will go to some two young men. The first young man joined us from Uganda just this year, and the time was more or less virtual lessons. But this young man has been consistent in everything he does. Ever smart, the compound, his teachers have got accolades of what he does, and all his predictions are 3A grades, and that goes to Alvaro Achola. Now, the other student joined us, I think, way back in year 10, with no English at all. Very friendly, sociable, great sense of group dynamics, has participated in nearly every other sport, and by the time he's leaving, his written and spoken English has improved beyond all recognition, and that's just a testament to his flexibility and dedication. And that is Yuyang. Thank you guys, Alvaro and Yang. Now, for the year 12, just as the year 13, it's quite been a challenge, but the student I'm going to give the Head of Year prize is a very warm and friendly student who cares about those around her. This has been evident in her representation of our tutor group right from year 10 all the way to year 12 right now. She's not the strongest in terms of academics, but she works hard to get her grades. And that positive approach to her studies has always made her be with the very, very top of her class. And that prize goes to Wendy Githinji. Well done, Wendy. Thank you.
Now, the special prizes. Special prizes are generally given to year 13 students for their contribution to a subject throughout their time at Hillcrest. Most of the prizes have been done as donations from former parents who want their child, they want themselves to be remembered for the time that they were at Hillcrest. So we'll start with Toady of the Year is Ryan Nduma. The Interact Prize for a contribution to the community is Ari Nduma, Masimbi Masidza, and Sarai Okwiri. The Scholars Prize, Ariana Gautama and Suhana Varsani. The Rainey Memorial Prize for Chemistry goes to Abdul Warsami. The Hartley Prize for Biology goes to Wanjiru Feldman. The Nathan Francisco Award for Physics is to Athiel Madding. The Glyn Duffield Prize for Outstanding Mathematics goes to Dev Shah. The Julius Gashai Best Economist goes to Colin Basinghe. The Julius Gashai for Excellent Contribution to Economics is Inderjit Garayal. The G. L. Vidyarthi Prize for English goes to Matthew Githinji. The Frank Thompson Prize for Creative Writing goes to Salam Tashome. The R. D. Stevens Prize for Drama goes to Amber Okello. The Nora Woods Prize for Performing Arts goes to Melissa Mwangi. The Moss Music Prize, a contribution to music, is Stella Ising. The Kaushal Prize for Sport for Boys goes to Matthew Githinji, and the Kaushal Prize for Girls goes to Chelsea Matu. Okay, despite the fact that students didn't write any exam papers last year because of the COVID pandemic, they did still get awarded results for their subjects. So it's normal in school that we award the students who've done outstandingly well in their exams a special award. Frank Thompson, who was the founder of the school, created the Genesius Award for what was O-levels is now IGCSE, and I will read you those who've done exceptionally well. So Isabella Riley got 5 A stars, 1 A, 1 B. Emma Langerfeld got 5 A stars, 3 A's, 1 B. Sahan Parik got 5 A stars and 4 A's. Anum Haria Shah got 6 A stars and 3 A's. Maya Hooper got 9 A stars. Ashika Techa got 9 A stars. And Redia Tai got 9 A stars. Well done. Also, for A levels, the Chandaria Award was created by the Manu Chandaria family, and that's for outstanding A level results. So Noah Oz got 2 A stars, 1 A. Shivangi Krishna got 3 A stars and 1 B at AS. Rihanna Gulam got 3 A stars and 1 A at AS. Eamon Ramji got 3 A stars and 1 A at AS. And Shay Harrier got 3 A stars and 1 A at A level. So well done, everyone.
We now turn to the head teacher's special prize and recognition awards. This year, I'm going to make 3 nominations. The first nomination, for performing his role with dignity and diligence, helping to organize the prefects and supporting the school in these trying times of pandemic, I'm going to make the award to Matthew Githinji. The second award goes to someone who has triumphed over adversity and excelled in all of her academics, and it goes to Athiel Madding. The third and the final award goes to someone who joined us in year 12. He's excelled in his academics, but the real reason I'm giving this to him is for his social awareness and for all of the work that he does outside of school, helping those who are less fortunate than those of us who come to Hillcrest. And that award goes to Ryan Nduma. Our best wishes go to all of our year 13 leavers and our year 11 leavers. We wish them all the best in their future academics and every success in their future careers.
Okay, the Agalor Nokolo Scholarship Award. A few years ago, well, 2005, Gloria Agalor left Hillcrest having been through the prep and the secondary school the whole way through. She was head girl at the prep, she was head girl at the secondary. An outstanding student academically, she was an outstanding sportswoman, she contributed to the community, she was involved in music, she was involved in drama, she was involved in everything. Two or three years ago, she wrote to me and said she would like to give back to the Hillcrest community, and she has created an award which is for a year 13 student who is not just outstanding academically, but they have made a huge contribution in every aspect of Hillcrest, drama, sport, music, charity, everything. So each year we send her a few names, and from that she herself selects the winners. So one boy and one girl. As it happens, this year she could not decide on which of the girls to finalise on, so she has selected two girls, so each is going to get 25,000 shillings, and those two girls are Doris Nsanzimana and Nina Redinger. And the boy, who is getting 50,000 shillings for his contribution to the school, is Matthew Githinji.
Finally, I'm going to announce the new incoming leadership team for the coming academic year. As usual, this has been an extremely difficult decision to take. All of the applicants were strong, all of them had their merits, but as usual, a decision has to be taken as to who will be the new head of school and who will be the two deputy heads of school. The first deputy head of school is Keith Munger. The second deputy head of school is McKenna Mugambi. The head of school this year will be Emma Langefeldt. I'm sure that all of the prefects will do a fantastic job. I was impressed with all of them. And hopefully they'll have an easier job to do this coming year than the prefects of last year, because hopefully we'll all be able to come back to Hillcrest School physically in September and remain so throughout the academic year. Thank you.
Okay, before we all go home, can I say thank you all for coming along, enjoying the evening. I hope you've enjoyed it and it will create some memories for you. Thank you to everyone who has contributed in any way. The teachers have provided names, nominations and everything else. To Toyin, who's spoken to you from all the way from America, to Gloria, who's provided an award from Canada, to everyone, go home, you can have your glass of wine and your bitings at home. Have a good year and all the best.